Dogs can't mask up like we can, but if they had a choice, they probably would because pollen season is here.
Dogs with pollen allergies, which are very common, tend to really struggle with this late summer, early fall season.
Dr. Rob Memon, the co-owner of Gehrman Animal Hospital, says itchy pups are super common right about now.
70 to 80% of the patients we see are experiencing allergies to some degree. Sometimes it's so mild, people just write it off to, oh yeah, they like to clean their paws a lot, they groom a lot.
That's because dogs don't manifest allergic reactions the same way as we do.
It's just a matter of where those histamine-releasing cells are concentrated. So in people, it's our sinuses. In dogs, it's their skin, their paws, their face, their ears, their belly. When I feel my allergies starting to get bad in the late summer, I know I'm gonna start getting a lot of calls from patients.
And it's peak ragweed season in our area, one major culprit for pollen. Pollen.com is forecasting medium to high levels all week. So how do we fix this?
These allergens don't come from animals coming in direct contact with the skin. It's really more from them inhaling these pollens, and then their body reacts to it through their skin. So it's very difficult to avoid all allergens for most dogs. So we will often treat really mild cases in similar ways to we treat people.
Ever hear of dogs being allowed to take over-the-counter antihistamines? Yep, these work on them too. Prescription sprays to help reduce swelling and itching may be an option as well.
If those aren't effective, then we'll often use prescription strength medications. Or now we have antibody therapies where we can give an injection of antibody to help neutralize some of those allergies.
Dr. Memon says dogs who may have been fine during puppyhood may continue developing allergic reactions for the first 1 to 3 years of their lives. So that pandemic puppy may have been fine last fall, but this year might require a trip to the vet.
One of the good things about us spending more time at home and with our pets and our families is you start to notice little things that maybe you were coming and going and a little too busy to catch in years past. So it's definitely something that we know we're gonna face, especially this time of year. But the good news is veterinarians can help take care of this. So I encourage people to reach out to their veterinarian.
Good advice, obviously, from a veterinarian. And also good advice. This kind of allergic reaction is different from an acute reaction, like the kind your pet might get from a bug bite or a bee sting. Those require immediate attention. So pay attention and keep that in mind.